Hello everybody, and a very warm welcome to LMT YouTube channel.
The Duke of Sussex celebrates his 36th birthday following an eventful year that has transformed his life.
When you look past the amputees, when you look past the burns, they're still the same people, and to be able to call them all my comrades, friends, whatever, because we all share something. We share that uniform, we share the training, we share, in some cases,
first time for who?
It's very special.
A pivotal moment that captured the world's attention, Princess Diana walking through an active minefield. Her youngest son now making this same walk more than 20 years later.
We will do everything we can to make sure that she's never forgotten and carry on all of the special gifts as such that she had and that she portrayed while she was alive. I hope that a lot of my mother's talents are shown in a lot of the work that I do.
This is not down to the black community. This is down to every single person that is on the planet right now. Why wouldn't you want to be part of this solution? And that to me is, if you can't answer that honestly, then again, I think you're part of the problem rather than part of the solution.
My wife said recently that our generation and the ones before us haven't done enough to right the wrongs of the past. I too am sorry. Sorry that we haven't got the world to the place that we deserve it to be.
Harry is now living in California with wife Megan and son Archie after they made the Sunshine State their home just before the coronavirus lockdown began in March. The couple are likely to celebrate the Duke's birthday, September 15th, privately at their Santa Barbara home as prevalent COVID-19 cases have forced many bars to shut and restaurants to close their indoor spaces in the coastal city. The celebrity hotspot, where the couple recently bought a $14.3 million property, has also experienced the after effects of California's wildfires with falling ash and red skies reported by residents in recent days. Harry and Meghan's new life in America is progressing fast, and the couple announced at the start of September they had signed a deal with Netflix to create films and programs estimated by an industry expert to be worth more than $250 million. The couple stepped down as working royals in March for financial and personal freedom, and the contract has enabled them to pay back the $3.1 million of taxpayers' money used to renovate Frogmore Cottage, their UK home in the grounds of Windsor Castle. Prince Harry is planning to spend his birthday with wife Meghan Markle and son Archie Harrison. But in addition to celebrating with his wife and son, Harry is likely to be visited by another family member. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex, who withdrew as senior royals earlier this year, could be joined by Meghan's mother, Doria Ragland. Doria lives in Los Angeles, which is a mere 90 miles and 1.5-hour drive away from Santa Barbara. Although Harry's birthday plans have not been revealed, it's likely it will be a quiet spent at their home. All individuals living in the state of California are currently encouraged to stay home and then only meet in small groups due to the ongoing coronavirus pandemic. But despite restrictions in place, Prince Harry is unlikely to have his day pass without a big fuss. The Duchess of Sussex is surely ready to celebrate her husband of 2 years in a special way. Members of the royal family are also likely to take to social media to congratulate the prince, as they are currently unable to meet in person. Last year, Meghan celebrated Harry with a sweet message posted to the now inactive Instagram account Sussex Royal. The post read, wishing a very happy birthday to His Royal Highness Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex. Adding a message from Meghan, it said, your service to the causes you care so deeply for inspires me every day. You are the best husband and most amazing dad to our son. We love you. Happiest birthday. His 35th birthday last year also marked his first as a father. Young Archie, now 16 months, was born on May 6, 2019 in London. Last month, Meghan celebrated her 39th birthday, also in California. To celebrate, the royal family posted photos of the Duchess with sweet messages. On the royal family's Twitter account, a photo of the Queen and Meghan at a 2018 joint visit to Chester was shared, wishing the Duchess of Sussex a very happy birthday. Harry's brother Prince William and his wife Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, also shared a photo of Meghan on their Twitter account, wishing a very happy birthday to the Duchess of Sussex today. We just want to annoy you for 3 seconds. That is, please click the subscribe button to get more attractive videos from us. Your support is also the motivation for our team to produce better videos with more quality content. And now we do not let you wait any longer. Let's start the story. The rules you have to follow if you hire Harry and Meghan. As Prince Harry and Meghan Markle move further away from their former duties as royals, the couple has been actively engaged in finding ways to achieve financial independence. And their efforts are already working. In early September 2020, Harry and Meghan signed a deal with Netflix, which is estimated to be worth close to $150 million. With things moving ahead financially, the couple has already paid back the nearly $3 million in renovations of their Frogmore Cottage home, which was initially covered by taxpayers through the Sovereign grant. While the Netflix deal was a huge step for the couple, Harry and Meghan are also paving the way to become guest speakers. The couple is working with the New York-based Harry Walker Agency, a group famous for also representing Oprah Winfrey and former presidents Barack Obama and Bill Clinton. Now, a document has been leaked revealing Harry and Meghan's rules that must be followed should they be hired to speak at an event. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle want to know who their audience is. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's new public speaking enterprise came with a list of requirements. Calling it a list of demands seems way too intense, since their rules are pretty reasonable. The 4-page document, called the Virtual Event Request Form, stipulates that the couple wants to choose who moderates the event and introduces them. They want to make sure they're paid upfront. As the form says, the fee will need to be paid directly from the contracting organization's account. In addition, Harry and Meghan wish to know how many guests will be attending and receive a description of who they are. The couple also wants to know about sponsors and who's responsible for funding the event, as well as what they are receiving in return for their sponsorship. Harry and Meghan want to know who else is speaking, as well as any live or pre-recorded program elements at the event and what the audience will see on screen. They also want to be informed about the connection format in case of technological difficulties. Considering the massive public profile Harry and Meghan have, it seems like good sense to carefully plan ahead for any event, putting them in the spotlight even more. Also, considering how heavily they'd been scrutinized in the past, it's understandable they'd simply like to know what they're getting into. Check out one of our newest videos right here, plus even more LMT videos about your favorite stuff. For coming soon, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one. Stop.